Hi, this is Jelan Cumberbatch, entrepreneur in the field of artist management. Now, this contract we'll be talking about today is a live performance agreement contract, which is used for promoters to book artists or entertainers. Now, most of these contracts basically should have a couple of the important things. So I'll just highlight the things that the contract should be, because these contracts, some of them are very lengthy and very complicated with a lot of different clauses. Main things that it should have would be the time of the performance, the date of the performance, the country and location of the performance, of course, the promoter information, which would be their full name, contact number, email address, even website if necessary. Also, the price agreed upon between the promoter and the agent or the manager of the artist. Also, it should have certain clauses and stipulations. So it would have the act of God clause, which would be if there's a natural disaster happen in the country on either the promoter or the artist, then there's something that could be worked out there. So that's the act of God clause. Then they'll have, of course, the permits and insurance policies. This is something that is there to protect the artist. So when the artist goes to these different countries or different venues, that there's insurance in the venues. So in case something happens to the artist, which I would put i.e. Destra happened in that country, that insurance would cover Destra expenses or any artist expenses. That's why these things are actually in contracts, for these reasons, because anything could happen in any stage or any country, especially when you live in Trinidad and Tobago or your respective country. Also, they should have, in terms of the termination clause, if there is not a payment within a specific time of signing the contract, there should be a clause for that as well, which normally should be 30 days. If there's a payment after the 30 days or before the 30 days, then the contract will be void. And also, we should have in those contracts very specifically that a rider should be included. So when the rider is included in the contracts, that the rider itself would be a separate agreement that would be signed by the promoter. So the riders generally is a list of demands that an artist requires to perform or for a performance. So the rider is split into two. So there's a hospitality rider and there's a technical rider. The technical rider is the technical things that are needed for the artist. So would be the type of mic they want to use, the stage, the length or the size of the stage, so the type of any technical thing that would be necessary for the artist to perform at the maximum level, which normally would be stage equipment and that the song system stuff for the artist. Because if it's not up to the artist with that the artist is comfortable with, then obviously the artist can't perform to their full ability, and then there would be a problem. So that's why it's very necessary to make sure that these things are listed in detail on the rider, especially technical rider. Also, the technical rider, depending if it's not a band as a DJ, the DJ as well needs to provide what is necessary for them so they could perform at their maximum level if it's a DJ artist type of performance. The hospitality rider is the rider where you would need towels, the type of tent, drinks, napkins, or any of those type of things that would make the artist comfortable before the performance. So, or it would be generally really for backstage and for their personal space. So some artists, goes as far as having what type of Skittles and what color they want. And then, but generally, some people go overboard, but generally it's really just about, having finger foods, the type of drinks, the water, the towels, and those type of things. So when the artist finish or before the artist goes on stage, they are a very comfortable place. And after they come off stage, they could go to the tent or to the room, and it's designed specifically for them to rest and for them to really feel comfortable and be able to sign autographs, take pictures with fans after. Thanks for watching my latest vlog. Look out for the next one on artist management contracts.